Hi friends, this is Gautam. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about how to secure user mode and privilege mode. So let's we can see. So we will take look at how you can secure user mode and privilege mode. So privilege mode or enable mode. So by default, there is no authentication is required. So in last video session itself, we saw how the switch will be boot up. So once it will boot up, so it will ask for press return key to enter. So once you press enter key, it directly goes to the user mode. So here we can see. So if you are connecting a Cisco console cable to your router or switch, here's what happened. So it's directly boot up, then it will ask for press return to get started. Once you press enter, it will be directly going to user mode. Then you have to give enable password to enter into the privilege mode or enable mode. So we can going to secure that one. So simple password. The most simple option to protect your user mode is to add a password. Here's how to do this. So these are the configuration. So first of all, you can go to the global mode. In that global mode, you have to give line console 0. Once you can give line console 0, press enter. It will enter into the sub configuration mode. So here we can see config-line. Then I will create one password. So password is a keyword. Then you can give user defined password. So whatever password you want, you can set it here. I mentioned Cisco. Then login, then exit. This is the simple password configuration. So we configure password Cisco and use the login command. So once you are using login command means to tell the Cisco IOS to promote for this password. It will promote as this password. So what password we can set? Cisco. So next time you open the console, this will happen. So it's asking for password. So you have to type Cisco, then only it will enter into the user mode. And whenever you are typing password, it won't showing anything. Okay, then we can go to the enable, then it will goes to the privilege mode. So press return to get started. Once you press, it will asking for password. Then after typing password only, it will enter into the user mode. Okay, next one, username and password. So instead of single password, it also possible to use username and password. So this is a better option if you have multiple people that needs to access your router or switch. So instead of configuring password, we have to create username and password. So this is a better option if you have multiple people that needed access to your router or switch. So how to configure username and password? So again, you have to go to the under control settings. So here line console 0 under control settings. Here you have to give login local. So previously I given login, here I am giving login local. So the login local command tells the switch to refer to the local database of username and password for authentication. So local database means the running configuration of switch and router. So that one only we are saving local database. So login local means it will refers the local database of the switch and router to refer the username and password for the authentication. So in global config, we can create username and password. So here I will create username as a Cisco. So in global mode, you have to give username is a keyword and password. Username, whatever username you want, you can create, and password is a keyword, and whatever password you want, you can create. Here I mentioned Cisco. Okay, next time you open the console, here what you see? So it will asking for username and password. So username is a Cisco and password also Cisco. So whenever in Cisco IOS router and switch you are typing password, it won't showing anything. Okay, but in backend it will be entering. So username Cisco, password Cisco, it will enter into the user mode. From user mode to, you have to go to the privilege mode, you have to configure enable command. Okay, now we are going to secure enable mode or privilege mode. So whenever I'm saying enable mode or sometimes I'm saying privilege mode, both of them are same only. So we can also add a password for enable mode or privilege mode. So you need to do this form of configuration mode from the configuration mode. So in global mode, you have to give use enable. Enable is a user, is a keyword, and password also keyword. Then you have to give whatever password you want to set for enable mode. Here I mentioned Cisco. So next time if I'm entering into that, now it will asking for username and password. After username and password, it will enter into the user mode. From the user mode, I am entering into the global privilege mode, means I have to give enable command. Once I will give enable command, it will asking for password. So once I will type that password, then only it will enter into the privilege mode. So in the example above, we used passwords, but there is one problem. They all show up in clear text in our configuration. Take a look below. So we can set username, we can set password for user mode and enable mode. So whatever the username and password we created, everything will save it as a clear text. Here we can see show running-config pipe include password. So once you are using show running-config pipe include, so the pipe include indicates, so the password in the running configuration, what are the lines it include the password, that line will be fetching and will show it to you, show it to us. So here we can see include password, so no service password hyphen encryption, enable password Cisco, username password and password Cisco. So this is a, using this type of show commands we can fetch particular details. Okay, it's all clear text. If someone steals one of your switches or routers, they will have your password. So if you ever backup your configuration and forgot to remove the password, same problem. So this is not a secure. So Cisco IOS has command that lets you encrypt all the clear text password into configuration. So this is not a secure. So we have to, Cisco IOS have one command to encrypt all the passwords in the running configurations. So service password hyphen encryption. So using this command will encrypt every password in our, every password that is in plain text. What are the passwords in the plain text? Everything will be encrypted into using service password hyphen encryption. It will encrypt all the passwords. Here we can see in global mode, I just given service space password hyphen encryption. So these are the commands and keywords, predefined commands. Just given that command. Then afterwards, again, I am giving show running hyphen config pipe include password. Here we can see everything will be encrypted into type 7 encryption. But this type and type 7 encryption also not secure. We can easily crack this password. So here we can see password-decrypt.com. So if you are going to that website, here it's asking for Cisco 7 password. Once I will give one type 7 encryption and I will give submit, it will be easily decrypt and it will showing the password Cisco. So we can go for another method, secret. Instead of giving password, we can go for secret. So Cisco IOS supports something called secret as an alternative to the password. Let's try this for an enable mode. So So just in global mode, you have to give enable. Then previously we are giving password. Instead of that, we have to give secret and we have to give question mark. So here we can see 0, 5 line level. So 0 specifies an unencrypted password. 5 is a encrypted and line that unencrypted clear text. So level, we have to set the privilege level. So above you can see the switch supports MD5, PBK, DF2 and script hashes. So older iOS version only support MD5 authentication only. So just in switch, I will give enable secret, then I will give the password. So again, I will give do show run pipe include secret. So it will fetch that secret keyword. what are the lines we are using secret, that line will be fetching and it will be showing to us. So if you are giving show run pipe include secret, here we can see enable secret 5 and encryption. So now you find an MD5 hash in the configuration. So the 5 that you see behind enable secret is the algorithm that we use MD5 authentication. So here we are using MD5 authentication algorithm. So MD5 is not considered secure nowadays. So nowadays MD5 also not secure. So it's very easy to brute force simple passwords. Here we can see using this website, here we can asking for type 5 password. Type 5 password is a encryption, MD5 authentication password. So here we can give MD5 that encryption password, then we can crack that password. It automatically crack that password as a Cisco. So this one also not secure. So let's try one of the other algorithms that are considered secure nowadays. Here how you can select the algorithm for enable mode. So these commands are not supported in Cisco Packet Tracer. You can try it with GNS3 or real device. So switch in enable. Enable is in global mode. You have to give enable is a keyword. Then you have to give algorithm -type. So if you are giving algorithm -type, it will be showing MD5, script and SHA-256. So here I am using 256, SHA-256, that is BBK DF2 hashing algorithm I am using. So I will give enable is a keyword, algorithm -type also keyword, then I will give SHA-256, then I will give secret as Cisco. Show running -config pipe include secret. Here we can see this is an SHA-256 encryption password. So the 8 behind enable secret refers to the PBK DF2 hashing algorithm that we used. So older switch supports only MD5. In newer switch, it will be supporting that script and SHA-256 hashing algorithm. So here I am using SHA-256 hash algorithm. So this one only nowadays, yeah, secure, considered secure when compared to MD5. So in the example above, I changed the hashing algorithm for the enable mode, but we can also do this for usernames. So just for enable only, I changed the hashing algorithm. We can change it for username and password also. So this is the syntax. In global mode, you have to give username and whatever the username you want, you can configure it. Here I mentioned Cisco, then algorithm -type is a SHA-256 secret Cisco. So after configuring that one, my username now use SHA-256 as well, for password Cisco. So once I will give show running -config pipe include Cisco, it will be fetching this line. So here we can see this is a SHA-256 encryption key for the username and password. So the password Cisco. Okay. So next one is an external authentication server. So configuring username and secret on your Cisco IOS device is good practice, but it is not scalable. So if you have a network with multiple devices, you will have to configure your username and password for all the devices. For an example, if in my network I have 100 devices. So right now I have only one or two devices. I can configure manually. It's a good practice. So scalability means in future I will extend my devices. For example, 50 devices, 100 devices means it's too difficult to configure each and every device the username and passwords, secret passwords. So if you change the password also, you have to change all the devices for the same password. So instead of that, we can use external authentication server. So external authentication server means like TACACS and RADIUS. So using that one, we can. So external authentication server, TACACS and server is used for scalability purpose. So we can use that one. So if you want to learn more about TACACS and RADIUS server means, I will explain you in separate video session. Okay friends, so I hope in this video tutorial you can understand how to secure our user mode and privilege mode. So if you have any queries, please ping me in comment section. I will reply to your query. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Subscribe my channel for further updates. Thank you.